this, the French TGV, is the inspiration for high-speed channel tunnel trains of the future. With a cruising speed of 180 miles per hour, it's the fastest train in Europe. Thousands of people in Kent and South London believe trains like this will destroy the quality of their lives. But here in France, they've been living with high-speed trains for years. The TGV, on which new channel tunnel trains are being modelled, was launched in 1979. The French, although worried initially about the effect on the environment, are now mostly in favour, and many positively welcome the channel tunnel expansion.
I think it's a very good service. It's an opportunity for French people, and I suppose for English people also, to be able to travel across Europe very easily and very rapidly.
But do you not worry about the effect on the countryside?
I don't think it affects very much the countryside, more than planes or other nuisances.
When he leaves the town, the speed is not too fast, but he reaches the maximum speed in the country, so problem of noise or something like this are not too important.
I don't think that people have been worried about more noises or more difficulties for the countryside with a speed train or another train. It makes no difference.
The French are well ahead of the British in planning a high-speed link to the Channel Tunnel. A route from Paris to the coast has already been chosen and will be ready when the tunnel opens. Negotiations start soon over compensation for any loss of land and housing. But unlike the enormous protest in Britain, there's very little opposition in France. Geographically, it's obviously been easier to plan the route. The north of France is much less densely populated than the south of England. But on the whole, the French railway company, SNCF, is credited for considering the environment.
Of course, usually when we study the line, we take into account all environmental aspects, and we try to forecast what we're going to do as protection for environment.
Have you avoided towns and villages in planning that route?
We try to avoid most as we can.
A watchdog transport group was certainly happy with the way the southern TGV route was developed.
The SNCF did what it should. It made its plans public, it consulted everyone, and it paid fair compensation to those who lost land.
In Kent and South London, protesters believe the noise of high-speed trains will seriously disrupt their lives. But the French who live with TGVs in the Paris suburbs now acknowledge they're not as noisy as they'd feared.
It goes by quickly and it makes less noise than other trains.
The Channel Tunnel traffic will use existing lines through the Paris suburbs, many of them underground. Further out, there's to be some new tunnelling to avoid damaging the countryside. Such measures have gone a long way to appeasing concern over the high-speed train. Indeed, the TGVs are said to have a positive effect in one area close to the heart of the French. One concern has been the effect on vineyards. But rail chiefs claim that in the case of Vouvray wine, the vibration of the passing train actually improves the quality of the wine. Salut. Some light-hearted evidence that while British Rail face bitter accusations of bad planning and poor liaison with the public, it appears French railway chiefs have, in good humour, succeeded in allaying many fears of environmentalists. When the Channel Tunnel opens in 1993, Paris will be just 3 hours from London by train. Here in France, a high-speed link will run from the capital to the coast from day one. But as protest grows in England, it remains uncertain when a British high-speed link will be built. This is Teresa Driscoll in Paris for Thames News.